Hello everyone, good morning all of you. Welcome to you all in today's second lecture of chapter number 3. And the name of our chapter number 3 is A Trip to Bhopal. Today, again, we start that remaining story, The Journey Begins. Let us see. Manjit says that it is very far. So Mr. Bhimsen says that it is about 70 kilometer only. Ruby says that are we going to stop anywhere? So Mr. Rakesh says that maybe at Bhimbetka, about 50 kilometer from here. After that, someone says, if they go to Bhimbetka, they will reach there before 10 o'clock, between 10 o'clock and 11 o'clock, or after 11 o'clock. As you already remember that at 9 o'clock they departure from the school, and to reach the Bhopal, it takes 2 hours. If they are not taking rest anywhere then, so we can say they can reach between 10 o'clock to 11 o'clock. Now the next one. As they are talking, the Bahadur shouts, hey, look at the Narmada. They all are enjoying their trip in the bus. Everyone looks out of the windows. Then after, Ruby says that wow, it is so long and so wide. Let us guess how wide it is. So Gopi says that it's all about 100 meters. No, it is much more. Can't say. Then Victoria says that it must be more than half a kilometer. After that, Miss Asa says that, look, it is written, the bridge is 756.82 meters long. So we can guess that the Narmada must be about 500 meters wide at this place. Was Victoria right? Yes, Victoria was right, because the bridge is 756.82 meters long. So, the Narmada must be wide more than 500 meters. Sadaf says that, I just can't imagine 500 meters. So, Miss Asa says that, see, our bus is about 5 meters long. Now imagine, how many bus can stand in a line on this bridge? So you just think here, the length of one bus is 5 meter and the bridge, the size of bridge is 756.82 meter. So just do the division, 756.82 by 5. So we can say 151 bus. So in that bridge, 151 bus can be stand in a line on the bridge. Have you ever crossed a long bridge? The bridge like this, about how many meters long was it? Yes, I have crossed a long bridge and it was about the 500 meters long. Everyone looks down at the river. So Mr. Rakesh says that the water level now is quite low. It must be about 40 meters below the bridge. So Miss Asa says that, but in the rainy season, the water had risen. Then it was just about the 15 meters below the bridge. Right now, the water level below the bridge and it's about 40 meters. But when in the rainy season, the water has risen and it's just about only the 15 meters below the bridge. So what is the difference between the water level of Narmada in a rainy season and now? So here you can see just here in this they are doing the comparison of water level in rainy season and in present time. So what we have to do, whenever you have to do any of the comparison, you have to just do the subtraction from 40 meters minus 15 meters. So we can say the 25 meters. So the difference between the water level of Narmada in rainy season and at present, it's a 25 meter. The children discussed about the river for some time. Suddenly, the bus stopped with a jerk. Oh, the petrol pump. Two buses need to be refilled because the petrol is empty. The bus stand in a line. Children are sticking their necks out to see how the diesel is filled in the bus. Some children have got down to look more closely. What happened? The buses are, how they feel, that all things. They all are very excited to see these all things. Each bus take about 15 minutes to refill. And there are two buses to be refilled. So they stop there for about how many minutes? Which means they are late about how many minutes? So we can say that to refill the one bus tank, it takes 15 minutes. And how many buses are there? Two buses are there. So what we have to do? We have to find out how many minutes they are late. So one bus is equal to 15 minutes. So two bus is equal to question mark. So we can say 2 multiplied by 15 is equal to 30 minutes. Or we can say for half an hour. So they are late about 30 minutes or by an half an hour. See in this picture, the children are just discussing about the petrol tank. Hey, it has such a big tummy. Here they are talking about the tummy of that tank. It has already taken 100 liters. So we have to pay 3500 rupees for the diesel. So here they are just see the first time. So they all are very excited and they are discussing inside that the tummy of this petrol tank is too much big. It has 100 liters of petrol in that. And so how many? They just calculate how many money they have to pay. So they says that we have to pay 3500 rupees. Find the cost of 1 liter of diesel. So we can say how many total money they are given? 3500 divided by 100. So 3500 divided by 100 is equal to 35 rupees. As the bus are being refilled, some children go to the toilet near the petrol pump. Aman has taken as much time to empty himself as one bus is taking to refill. So here you just understand. Children are talking that Aman has taken as much as time to empty himself, one bus is taking to refill. Now you remember how much time one bus take to refill his tank? So how much time did Aman take to come out of the toilet? So we can say if one bus are taking 15 minutes to refill the tank, therefore Aman also take 15 minutes. Thank you all of you. I hope you all are enjoy this story and you understand the different concepts regarding the word problem. Thank you.